Magandang araw, Kapamilya. Today is Tuesday of the 32nd week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. Let my prayer come into your presence. Incline your ear to my cry for help, O Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, graciously keep from us all adversity, so that unhindered in mind and body alike, we may pursue in freedom of heart the things that are yours. Our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Book of Wisdom. God formed man to be imperishable. The image of his own nature he made them. But by the envy of the devil, death entered the world, and they who are in his possession experienced it. But the souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace, for if before men, indeed, they be punished, yet it is their hope full of immortality, chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine, and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love. Because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. I will bless the Lord at all times.
I will bless the Lord at all times.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall be ever in my mouth. Let my soul glory in the Lord. The lowly will hear me and be glad.
I will bless the Lord at all times.
The Lord has eyes for the just, and the ears for their cry. The Lord confronts the evildoers to destroy remembrance of them from the earth.
I will bless the Lord at all times.
When the just cry out, the Lord hears them. And from all their distress he rescues them. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted, and those who are crushed in spirit he saves.
I will bless the Lord at all times.
Alleluia, alleluia. Whoever loves me will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the apostles, "Who among you would say to your servant who has just come in from plowing or tending sheep in the field, 'Come here immediately and take your place at table'? Would he not rather say to him, 'Prepare something for me, to eat, but put on your apron and wait on me while I eat and drink'? You may eat and drink when I am finished. Is he grateful to that servant because he did what was commanded? So should it be with you. When you have done all you have been commanded, say, 'We are unprofitable servants. We have done what we are obliged to do.'" My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Let me invite you to reflect on I think three virtues, so to speak, no, of being a disciple, no, or being a follower of Christ. No, number one is the sense of duty. No, and then number two is a sense of not a sense of obedience, but obedience itself. No, and then the third is humility. No, when you take a look at these three virtues, no, first you take a look at the sense of duty. No, here you have here the servant, no, who was simply doing what he's supposed to do. No, so I think what is very important for us is to develop a very strong and clear sense of duty. No, for me, remember what you've always also reflected on is how the Lord criticized, no, the people who eventually develop a sense of entitlement. No, because they felt that they're occupying a position. After a while, the position gets into their head, no? And so what happens there is that they no longer have a sense of duty, but a sense of entitlement, no? And I think the sense of duty is very fundamental, no? Very basic, no? We must feel that whatever we are doing, that is our duty, no? We are expected to do that, and so therefore, we are simply doing what we are supposed to do, no? And then, together with that, and perhaps a deeper form, no, of sense of duty is a sense of obedience, no? And when you take a look at the Lord's own journey, no, in fulfilling the will of the Father, remember towards the end, no, and not only towards the end, but it becomes very, very pronounced in the end, no, that sense of obedience, which is a loving obedience, no? Remember what we mentioned that during many moments, no, in the ministry of the Lord, especially in the Gospel of Luke, from which we are reading, you always see that beautiful line, no, and he went off to a deserted place to pray by himself. No, after a major event or before a major event, you always see that, no, the Lord always spending time in solitude with his Father. No, and remember what we said, no, that you would realize that these moments of solitude and prayer was for the Lord to check in, so to speak, no? He wanted to make sure that he was doing his mission according to the Father's will, totally according to the Father's will. And as we mentioned also before, no, that we see one of the moments we see this moment of solitude and prayer is in the agony in the garden, no? And there you see very clearly how the Lord, because of his very deep and personal relationship with the Father, is able to express what was in him. No, Lord, let this cup, if it is possible, let this cup pass me by, no, pass away from me. And then you see now the obedience. Father, not my will, but your will be done. So that second point, no, duty, obedience. And in the case of our Lord, it was loving obedience that brought about our salvation. No? And then the third virtue, no, is humility. No, humility. I think when everything is said and done, no, it is that sense of humility that allows us to be lovingly obedient. But I think ultimately, after the obedience comes a sense of humility, that we are simply, or perhaps not simply, but we are blessed to be instruments in the hands of God. So I think for me that is one of the most moving sources of humility, no? To realize that yes, we are unworthy, but also to realize we are instruments in the hands of God because of our sense of duty and because of our sense of loving obedience, no? We become instruments in his hands, and that is humility, no? And I think one of the persons who very beautifully exemplifies these three virtues, no, of duty, of obedience, and humility is Simeon. Remember, in the mystery of the presentation, also in the Gospel of Luke, no, day in, day out, no, Simeon would go to the temple to pray. Remember that sense of duty, no. Remember, because he was promised by God that his mission was to be able to see the Savior, no. But every day, with a sense of duty, he goes to the temple, awaiting the Savior, awaiting for the salvation of Israel. So that sense of duty. And then finally, that sense of obedience, no? That finally when the Spirit leads Simeon, no, to be able to see the Savior in the child Jesus, no? And remember, every time we allow the Spirit of God to lead us, that is for me the in a sense, in quotation marks, the hallmark of Christian obedience. When we move, when we think, and we act according to the Spirit, in the same way that Simeon, no, acted, led by the Spirit, no, led him to the Savior, led him to Christ, no. And then third, the humility of Simeon, no. Of course, that beautiful nunc dimittis of Simeon. Now, Master, you can dismiss your servant in peace, for my eyes have seen the salvation, the light to the nations, no. And there you see Simeon's humility, no. Siguro magandang pag nilayan natin itong tatlong puntong ito sa ating buhay. Tanungin natin ang ating sarili, meron malakas ba yung ating sense of tungkulin, no? Kasi yun yung duty, yung ating tungkulin. Alam ba natin, malinaw ba sa atin kung anong ating mga tungkulin, ano? Dahil sa katapusan, no, bilang mga katiwala ng Diyos, tayo ay nanunungkulan dito sa mundo, no? Kamusta ang ating panunungkulan, yung ating sense of duty? Tapos yung pangalawang punto ay sabi nga natin kaugnay nitong ng ating katungkulan ay ang pagtalima, no. Mahalaga sa lahat na yung ating pagsasabuhay, no, ng ating misyon, ang mga gawain natin, bagaman mahalaga na magsimula yan na malinaw na ito itungkulin natin, sa katapusan mahalagang palalimin din natin ito sa isang mapagmahal na pagtalima sa misyon at kagustuhan ng Diyos, no. So yung pangalawang punto. At ang naglalagom, ano, para sa akin, naglalagom ng lahat ng ito, ang nagbibigay, kumbaga, ng bagong anyo sa atin, ng pagbabalik loob, pagbabagong loob, ay ang kababaang loob, no? Dahil nga dito sa ating malinaw na tungkulin, sa ating mapagmahal na pagtalima, sa katapusan yan ay nagbubunga sa isang napakagandang kababaang loob. Dahil alam natin tayo ay mga instrumento sa kamay ng Diyos. So today, let us pray that we may be able to see all of this in our lives, no? To be able to evaluate ourselves. How are we living out our sense of duty? Have we grown into becoming disciples of Christ who show loving obedience to the will of the Father in the sharing of the mission with Christ? And then do we feel that sense of humility as instruments in the hands of God? Let us pray to our Heavenly Father that you may learn from Jesus, His Son, the spirit of loving service.
That the Pope, the bishops, and priests may faithfully serve in the household of faith with diligence and dedication, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That leaders in our society may become true servants by diligent efforts in bringing the common good to all rather than seeking their selfish gains, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may grow in our commitment to justice and love through our dedicated service in everyday life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us pray for all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. We continue to pray for peace, and we continue to pray for the intentions of the Holy Father, especially for his prayers for peace. And let's also pray for all the souls of the faithful departed, especially commended to our prayers during our November Masses. For all this, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Look with favor, we pray, O Lord, upon the sacrificial gifts offered here, that celebrating in mystery the passion of your Son, we may honor it with loving devotion through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. With love we celebrate his death. With living faith we proclaim his resurrection. With unwavering hope we await his return in glory. And so with all the angels and saints we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. We pray most specially for all the souls of the faithful departed, specially commended to our prayers during this month of November. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
we take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us offer Pope Francis's prayer for peace.
Lord God of peace, King of heaven and earth, hear our prayer. We have tried so many times and over so many years to resolve our conflicts by our own powers and by the force of our arms. How many moments of hostility and darkness have we experienced? How much blood has been shed? How many lives have been shattered? How many hopes have been buried? But our efforts have been in vain. Now, Lord, come to our aid. Grant us peace. Teach us peace. Guide our steps in the way of peace. Open our eyes and our hearts, and give us the courage to say, never again war. With war, everything is lost. Instill in our hearts the courage to take concrete steps to achieve peace. Lord, God of love, you created us, and you call us to live as brothers and sisters. Give us the strength daily to be instruments of peace. Enable us to see everyone who crosses our path as our brother or sister. Make us sensitive to the plea of our citizens who entreat us to turn our weapons of war into implements of peace, our trepidation into confident trust, and our quarreling into forgiveness. Keep alive within us the flame of hope, so that with patience and perseverance, we may opt for dialogue and reconciliation. In this way, may peace triumph at last, and may the words division, hatred, and war be banished from the heart of every man and woman. Lord, diffuse the violence of our tongues and our hands. Renew our hearts and minds, so that the word which always brings us together will be brother, sister, and our way of life will always be that of shalom, peace, salam. Amen. Our Lady, Queen of Peace,
pray for us. And let us pray. Nourished by the sacred gift, O Lord, we give you thanks and beseech your mercy, that by the pouring forth of your Spirit, the grace of integrity may endure in those your heavenly powers entreated, has entered through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace, to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Maraming pong salamat and have a good day ahead. Thank you po.
I can't feed 5,000, but I can feed one. I can't walk on water, but I can walk in the shoes of another. Sharing what I have in my hands is the miracle that needs to be seen today. This is what I can share. This is my Alay Kapwa. Alay Kapwa, a flagship program of Caritas Philippines by the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines.